The first time I heard Fusel, I thought it's a, like someone's making a joke. You have to sometimes remember, okay, this is an actual human being.
Stoppst du Schwinnisch und Schwinnisch?
Don't do your makeup last minute. Ich fühle mich als Berliner.
Kita, liebe Freunde, was geht ab? Heute ist es nach langem tatsächlich mal wieder Zeit für ein wirklich sinnvolles Video, denn
es ist wieder Zeit für Beauty Talks.
Beauty Talks.
Iga, was geht ab? Alles fresh?
Ja.
Was überhaupt ist Schönheit? Für uns persönlich, in anderen Ländern? Und warum ist Europa schön? Das und vieles mehr bespreche ich ab sofort in den Beauty Talks mit unterschiedlichen Persönlichkeiten aus den Mitgliedstaaten. Check it out! Check it, check it, yeah! Check it, check it, check it.
Immer wenn ich Leuten erzähle, dass wir zusammenarbeiten oder wenn ich dich reference, dann weiß ich immer nicht, wie ich deinen Nachnamen aussprechen soll. Wie wird der richtig ausgesprochen?
Drabisch.
Du hast ja selber auch als Model gearbeitet eine Zeit lang. Inwiefern hat das dein Verständnis von Schönheit beeinflusst?
I did it full-time for a while and I started quite early. And I think this is just too early to put a girl that still has so much to learn in such a position where everyone has something to say about your body, your proportions, your measurements. This takes over your entire life, what you eat and how you take care of yourself.
And how has your view on beauty changed since you switched sides? Like your perspective literally changed because you're now a photographer and you're now in the other position.
I feel like because I did this job, I tried to give a little bit more like voice and more comfort to my models, from making sure that they're warm enough, that they have something to drink, or just asking them if there's something that they would like to maybe propose, a little pose or something, you know? You have to sometimes remember, okay, this is an actual human being.
Wie hat deine polnische Herkunft dein Verständnis von Schönheit geformt?
Ja, gute Frage. Growing up with my mom made me pay attention to where I get my products from, what are the ingredients, what conditions is it made, and this was like 90s in Poland, people were not really thinking about that. She makes so much of her cosmetics just by herself, natural oils and things like that.
Did you learn anything to make yourself from her?
I do my own peeling, yeah.
Oh yeah?
And I use honey from my grandparents that are beekeepers.
Oh, nice.
Another thing is I was really shocked looking at how much money women spend on beauty per month in different countries. I really couldn't believe it. How I grew up, definitely beauty produkte or a spa beauty salon, that was not a priority. That taught me to be really resourceful, so it's not just peeling, you know. I do nails by myself and pretty much everything.
Du hast dich ja ein bisschen schön gemacht für mich heute. Was hast du denn geschminkt und warum?
I did a little bit more extra for this. I'm gonna say moisturize, and that's like something that I do no matter what, even if I'm in like super mega island in Russia. I do love bronzer. I think you have the same one from Dr. Hauschka.
Yes.
Which is also a cream, right? So it's like a two-in-one Pflege und Schönheit.
Is there something in your beauty routine you do different than everybody else?
Mein einziger Beauty Tip für heute. Don't do your makeup last minute. I try to do it a little bit before. I think it looks better when it's like a little bit settled and
soaked in.
Soaked in.
Inwiefern würdest du sagen, ist dein Geschmack polnisch?
Yeah, I think I just didn't grow up in a typical Polish surrounding. Where I come from, it's an interesting region because a lot of people are mixed. My mom is half black. A lot of people don't even know that they're mixed. 30% people are Orthodox. There has always been a Jewish community. There is mosques that are 400 years old, and it's all been there, which is rare in Poland. This is only like specific for this region. It's called Podlasia. In the 90s, my mom would dress up. She would put some outfits that she found in vintage stores inspired by newest Shade or Erika, but do video clip, and right now she doesn't do it.
Why?
It wouldn't be well received anymore. And to me it's crazy because it's not so long ago. And I have a great opinion about my town, about my city from the 90s, from when I remember growing up. Mm-hmm. And now I have a completely different opinion about it.
What has changed?
She doesn't feel so safe there anymore at the moment. And it's making me think a lot. It's pretty crazy, to be honest. Mm-hmm. I was mentioning before that this is like a region that there were four different religions. Yeah. And people seem to live in more or less harmony through centuries. The moshe that is there for 400 years is sprayed right now. The synagogue was burned. And this is just like literally just lately.
Du lebst ja jetzt seit knapp 5 Jahren nicht mehr in Polen, würdest du sagen?
10 Jahre.
Ach, 10 Jahre? Mhm. Echt? Okay, krass. Siehst du dich denn als Polin oder als Deutsche oder als Europäerin vielleicht sogar?
Ja, als Deutsche noch nicht. I can't even speak German properly yet. So we're not there yet. Polish, I didn't always feel like I fully maybe fit in somehow. Mhm. And it's been 10 years that I live in different European cities. So yeah, actually, European sounds good.
Yeah.
Or I can say, ich fühle mich als Berliner.
Was würdest du sagen, ist das Schönste an Europa?
I mean, it's amazing that we can just grab a passport, or not even passport, an ID, and just go. You know, like my grandparents didn't have that possibility, right? And I feel like we're so used to it that we forget to appreciate it.
What does the idea of an European Union mean to you?
I just think it's hard to face certain things individually. Mm-hmm. So this is 2019 and we have to think of the environment and the future of the planet. And this has to be faced, you know,
yeah,
all together.
Was sind einer deiner liebsten Sprichwörter oder Redewendungen auf Polnisch?
So I really like the Polish pronunciation exercises. You see, it's already happening. Chrząszcz brzmi w Trzcinie, w Szczebrzeszynie. That's a good one.
Stop, szczeszwinie, szczeszwinie, what? Chrząszcz
brzmi w Trzcinie. Chrząszcz, that's a little beetle, brzmi w Trzcinie. He's like making a little sound. And the last one is the name of an actual city.
Okay, Libiga, das war's. Vielen, vielen Dank. Schön, dass du da warst.
Yes. Ey, das war's!
Wir sehen uns nächstes Mal, wenn es wieder heißt Beauty Talks mit eurem Boy wieder am Stiffel.